فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. وإن شرح هذا الكتاب نزهة النظر في توضيح نخبة الفكر للحافظ ابن حجر العسقلاني رحمه الله، who died the year 852 رحمه الله. We spoke about صحيح and the most authentic book. We spoke about Bukhari's kitab is the most authentic, and then Muslim, and then anything that's on top of the condition of Bukhari and Muslim. And we mentioned the order for it. Today, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to go into the statement of the Shaykh rahimahullah, the Imam Hafiz ibn Hajar, where he says, فَإِنْ خَفَ الضَّبْطُ, if the precision reduces. Remember when we were speaking about the hadith, the sahih hadith, we said that there has to be three things that are present for the hadith to be sahih, and there's two things that have to be what? Absent, right? So one of the things that we said that has to be there for the hadith to be sahih is what? Tam al-dabt. The precision has to be complete. There has to be a complete precision. There has to be a what? A complete precision. The person has to be very precise. But if the precision reduces and it becomes less, then hadith becomes what? It becomes hasan. And remember we said, that's the only one that can reduce, that accepts reducing. The rest, they don't accept reducing. If adala reduces, or if ittisal al-sanad reduces, or if the other reduce, then it becomes what? It becomes a hadith which is mardut, rejected. So for it to be a hadith which is maqbul, accepted, it has to be what? The only thing that accepts tajzi'ah. The only thing that accepts at-taba'ud wa tajzi'ah, that would accept to be broken down, it has levels, is dabt. Dabt has a precision, can accept it. Hafiz ibn Hajar, he says in his Nuzhat al-Nadar, he says, فَإِنْ خَفَّ الضَّبْطُ أَيْ قَلَّ يُقَالُ خَفَّ الْقَوْمُ خُفُوفًا قَلُّ. So the Qamus al-Muhit mentions that the word khaffa means when something becomes less, it reduces. The Arabs, they say khaffa al-qawmu khufufan qallu, ay they became little. Wal-muradu, the intent here is ma'a baqiyati ash-shurut al-mutaqaddimati fi hadith sahih, he says. All of the other previous conditions that we mentioned for what? For sahih being in place. Only thing that reduces is the precision. فَهُوَ الْحَسَنُ لِذَاتِهِ. This hadith is now called what? It's called what? حَسَنُ لِذَاتِهِ. Even حَسَنُ لِذَاتِهِ and صحيح are different. What's the difference between حَسَنُ لِذَاتِهِ and صحيح? What's the difference? If somebody was to ask you, the difference between the two is that صحيح لذاته has what? The precision is tam al-dabt. The precision is 100%. I mean, the precision is there. It's complete. لكن حسن لذاته, the precision has reduced. Nothing else. This hadith is called حسن لذاته. If this hadith, which is حسن لذاته, it gets external narrations, other narrations come. It's حسن لذاته. The memorization is a bit reduced. Are we all together? But other narrations come. What happens? Stating the same thing that this hadith, which is حسن لذاته, has stated. What will the hadith now become? it will become صحيح لغيره. It's now called صحيح لغيره. كثرة الطرق. And إن شاء الله تعالى we will see it. حسن لذاته. According to the ulama of hadith, the people of hadith, حسن لذاته. According to the ulama المتقدمين, the early scholars, it is considered a type of صحيح. Back in the early ulama, Bukhari and Muslim, Abu Dawud, Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, Nasa'i, Ahmed and others, they, whenever they said this hadith is sahih, they also meant what? حسن لذاته. ولذلك you find they don't distinguish between the two. They don't believe there's something called sahih لذاته and حسن لذاته. They don't believe that. What they believe is that they're all what? They're all sahih. ولذلك you find a hadith in Bukhari which are حسن لذاته. Find a hadith which are in Bukhari which are حسن لذاته. الإمام الذهبي says in his كتاب الموقظة page 80 he says ما في الكتابين بحمد الله. The praise of Allah is that what's in the two books meaning Bukhari and Muslim is رجل احتج به أحدهما. It is narrators are in these books that the two authors Bukhari and Muslim have both used as evidence. وروايته ضعيفة ضعيفة بل حسنة أو صحيحة. That this narrator, he's weak. His narration is weak, but because of the fact that they found other narrations for it, it had each either reached what حسن لغيره or حسن لذاته or صحيح لغيره or صحيح لذاته. One of the four it carries. So the hadith which is حسن لذاته is محتج به عند جماهير أهل العلم. The hadith which is حسن لذاته is actually taken on board and it is actually a proof for the overwhelming majority of scholars. So from the scholars who rejected accepting a hadith which is weak, they don't mean by it حسن لذاته. This hadith, which is حسن لذاته, is one of the ahadith which the scholars, their difference of opinion, their khilafat, their disputes pertaining to it, is really high. Because to pinpoint that a narrator's memorization is a bit weak, it's one of the hardest things to pinpoint. It's hard to say. لذلك you find one narrator himself, will come one time and he will say this hadith is sahih. And then he would again come and say, no, it's حسن لذاته. And he then might come and say, no, it's ضعيف. One imam, Albani alone might do that. Because of how much it needs observation. And how it can hide. One of the ahadiths which are weak, but its weakness is very, very low. Does anyone know what it is? Do you guys know the least weak hadith? Yeah? Wudu' is the worst form of... Yeah, I said least weak hadith. Its weakness is the least. Okay. Plus, wudu' is not weak. The kadhib, it's not da'if. It's worse than weak. So the least weak hadith is mursal. The hadith which is mursal is the least weak hadith. And a mursal is when a tabi'i attributes something to the Prophet, when he says that the Prophet said. The hadith which is mursal, the scholars they say, since it's the least weak hadith, it should be given the same ruling as khifatul dabt, the precision below in the narrator. So if the hadith finds, the mursal finds a mutaba'a, other narrations to support it, it goes big. It can get pushed up. It can get what? It can get pushed up. So Hafiz rahimahullah, he says after that, وَبِكَثْرَةِ طُرُوقِهِ يُصَحَّحُ. He says, وَبِكَثْرَةِ طُرُوقِهِ. If the narrations of this hadith become more. So this, there's a narrator in this hadith. His memorization is not complete. It's a bit deficient. Other narrations have come and they support it. What do we now call the previous hadith that had the weak memory narrator in there? We now say this hadith is sahih li ghayri. It becomes sahih li ghayri. It pushes it up. وَبِكَثْرَةِ طُرُوقِهِ يُصَحَّحُ. And if you look at half of the statement here, which is وَبِكَثْرَةِ طُرُوقِهِ يُصَحَّحُ, half of the Hajar used itlaq of the word sahih. He didn't, he said يُصَحَّحُ. So we can refer to a hadith which is صَحِيحٌ لِغَيْرِهِ. We can just call it صَحِيح if we wish to. We're allowed to. Even that though it, صَحِيح consists of what? صَحِيحٌ لِذَاتِهِ صَحِيحٌ لِغَيْرِهِ. But you're allowed to do itlaq of the word sahih. You can unrestrictedly use the word sahih. You can say it's sahih. Even though it's what? It's the lower of the sahih. وَبِكَثْرَةِ طُرُوقِهِ يُصَحَّحُ. With its excessive narrations, it's made sahih. Hafidh ibn Hajar says in his kitab Nusat al-Nadar, في توضيح نقبة الفكر, he says, وَإِنَّمَا يُحْكَمُ لَهُ بِالصِّحَةِ. The hadith is graded to be sahih عِنْدَ تَعَدُّدِ الطُّرُقِ, when the riwayat, the tariq that it comes in, the means, the way that it comes, it's too much. لِأَنَّ لِلصُّورَةِ الْمَجْمُوعَةِ قُوَّةً تَجْبُرُ الْقَدْرَ الَّذِي قَصُرَ بِهِ طَبْطُ رَاوِي الْحَسَنِ عَنْ رَاوِي الصَّحِيحِ. Because the amount of narrations that have come have now supported and they've now aided the problem in the what? The narration which is hasanul lidati, which is the memory. We don't have to worry about the memory anymore. What has now taken place is tajburul qadr. Jabr is when a person breaks his arm. Have you seen it? The thing, the cuffs that he puts on. What's it called? The cuffs that he puts on. That's what happens. It's supporting the person's arm and helping their arm. Here, that narration which had low memory, the narrator that it was in there, his memory was low, is now being supported by what? It's being supported by these other narrations. So now it pushes it up. It aids it. It takes it up. And it takes it up to what? Sahihun. Sahihun li ghayrihi. It takes it sahihun li ghayrihi. ومن ثم تطلق الصحة على الإسناد. And then we can come and just say this hadith is sahih. الذي يكون حسنا لذاته لو تفرد إذا تعدد. The hadith which is حسن لذاته, if it was alone, we will now call it صحيح لغيره because of the large amount of narrations that have come. Very good. Then Hafidh ibn Hajar goes into a mas'ala, which is a issue which is very, very tricky, which is, first of all, before I move on, I really want us to understand, how many types of sahih are there? There are two types of sahih. How many types of hasan are there? There are two types of hasan. So two types of sahih and two types of hasan. So two types of sahih, and there are two types of hasan. The first type of sahih, the strongest type of sahih, is called sahihun lidatihi. Sahihun lidatihi. Sahihun lidatihi. What does sahihun lidatihi mean? It means when the hadith is sahih in and within itself. Are we all together? It's sahih with what? In and within itself, is the one that we took. It's the one that meets the criteria that we mentioned. It's the one we all call sahih. It's basically, we've spoken about it. It's the one that its chain of narration is connected. Are we all together? Its chain of narration is what? It's connected. The narrators are what? Reliable. The precision of the narrators are complete. What do you call it? Allahu musta'anu ala ma tasifun. What's the fourth one? There's no defect in the narration. And there's no also any opposition. There's no opposition in the narration. It doesn't oppose any other narration. Are we all together? This hadith is now called sahihun لذاتي, meaning صحيح in and within itself. That's why it's called لذاتي. It doesn't require any support from anybody. It's authentic in and within itself. That's called what? صحيح لذاتي. Now, the level lower than that is what? حسن لذاتي. We have to go to the لذاتي because the لذاتي is always more important than the صحيح لذاتي. حسن لذاتي is a hadith of what you just took right now from the صحيح. What did you just take صحيح? That is connected, the precision is there, the integrity of the narrators is there, this narration doesn't have any opposition, and there's no hidden defect, right? That's what we mentioned. حسن لذاتي, the only difference between صحيح لذاته and the حسن لذاتي is the memorization. The memory of the narrator is a bit low. That's it. It's not that it's gone, it's not as strong as the authentic one. Are we all together? That's now called what? حسن لذاتي. If the حسن لذاته gains extra narrations, other narrations that come, then what does it fall, what does it push up to? صحيح. It pushes up towards صحيح لغيره. So صحيح لغيره is just حسن لذاتي supported. That's what it is. It's just the حسن لذاتي supported by other narrations. Are we all together? I'll give you an example. We have a brother here who's strong. He doesn't need anyone to help him. He's capable of doing his work. He's what? He's صحيح لذاتي. This individual can do his own work. He doesn't really need anyone's help. He's got all the requirements and everything that's needed. This person we will say is what? صحيح لذاتي. Then we have a person who lacks the enthusiasm. They lack the enthusiasm. Or their focus is very low. They can't focus for very long. Okay, let's just say focus. Their focus is not up there. Are we all together? Does that make sense? The one who's doing everything himself and meets the criteria himself is called what? صحيح لذاتي. This one who lacks the focus, he can't focus on his work for too long. Every 20 minutes he's jumping, he's leaving his table, he's going somewhere else. This one is حسن لذاتي. He can do the job, but he won't be done as good as what? The one that can just do his own work and he's focused and he sits on his table and does everything. صح? If this one who's حسن, this one whose focus span is low, are we all together, gains help and support from other people around him on the desk who are going to help him. Whenever he stands up, they're going to bring him back. Oh, come and sit down, do your work. Are we all together? He now becomes what? His production is what? صحيح لغيره. Does that make it more easier for you guys to understand? Huh? This is all it is. صحيح لغيره. Does that make sense? Then we have a hadith which is weak. We have a hadith which is, are we all together? A ضعيف hadith. Are we all together? A hadith which is ضعيف. And the weakness of this narration is not excessive. It's not too much. If it comes together and their weakness is not severe and it gains support from another narration, maybe the chain of narration is disconnected. The chain of narration is what? The chain of narration is disconnected. But we gain support from other narrations. This hadith, which was now weak because it lacks a what? It lacks one of the five conditions. This disconnection is weak, it's da'if now. It's not hasan, it's not da'if. But if it gets support by other narration that helps it, what does it now become? It becomes hasan lighayrihi. Hasan lighayrihi is just a weak narration that has been pushed up. That's all it is. Does that make sense? It's a ضعيف hadith that has been pushed up. Does that make sense now to everyone? But here we have an issue. Hafiz Ibn Hajar points this. And this issue is, what would it be if, okay, we know now there's a difference between Sahih and Hasan. Are we all together? We know there's a difference between Sahih and Hasan. Do we not know? We know the difference. But why does Tirmidhi say Hadithun Hasanun Sahih? Why does Tirmidhi, when he comes in his Sunan or his Jami', what does he say? Hadithun Hasanun Sahihun. Are we all together? If they're two different things, how is he able to say Tirmidhi on one hadith, he now comes and he says it is Hasanun Sahih? This is where Hafidh al-Hajri yatatarraq ilayhi, he goes towards that now. And he speaks about it. He says, Hafidh al-Hajr, فَإِن جُمِعَا, if both of them are brought together, meaning Hasan and Sahih are both brought together, فَإِن جُمِعَا أَيْ الصَّحِيحُ وَالْحَسَنُ, if the Sahih and the Hasan are brought together, فَلِلْتَرَدُّدِ فِي النَّاقِلِ, فَلِلْتَرَدُّدِ فِي النَّاقِلِ is the first one he mentions. What is فَلِلْتَرَدُّدِ فِي النَّاقِلِ means? The scholar, like Tirmidhi, in his heart there is a doubt whether this hadith is Hasanun لِذَاتِهِ or صَحِيحٌ لِغَيْرِهِ فَلِلْتَرَدُّدِ فِي النَّاقِلِ. There is a taraddud here. Are we all together? He's having a doubt. فَلِلْتَرَدُّدِ فِي النَّاقِلِ. He's basically arguing, is the conditions of Sahih here or is the conditions of... And it's very common, as I said to you before, that even sometimes they may even differ on this narrator. He has khafiful dabt. Some say no, he's got tamul dabt. No, some say no, he's khafiful dabt. Does that make sense? They might differ on one narrator like that. Good. Very good. That's what the author says. فَلِلْتَرَدُّدِ فِي النَّاقِلِ حَيْثُ التَّفَرُّدِ. وَإِلَّا, if that's not the case then, فَبِعْتِبَارِ إِسْنَادَيْنِ, this hadith has come in two narrations. This same hadith has come in two narrations. One is Hasan and one is what? So Tirmidhi is trying to say صَحِيحٌ. When it's تَرَدُّد, what's half? When Tirmidhi says hadithun hasanun sahihun, the first reason he gave was what? What was the first reason he gave? فَلِلْتَرَدُّدِ فِي النَّاقِلِ. So there's a hidden word inside there, what Tirmidhi is saying, which is what? Or others who use it, is what? Hasanun. Oh, sahihun. Oh, is in the taraddud. Oh. Does that make sense? That's the first reason, explanation of Hafidh al-Hajr. وَإِلَّا فَبِعْتِبَارِ إِسْرَادَيْنِ, or this hadith has more than one chain. So one chain is Hasan and the other chain is Sahih. Are we all together? There's a issue that Hafidh, this statement of Hafidh ibn Hajar is truly not musallam. Both of those two answers are لا يسمن ولا يغني ولا يغني من جوع. What Hafidh ibn Hajar said here and the answer that he gave here, the reality is there's still an ishkal. Because if you go to the Kitab Sunan al-Tirmidhi, for example, you find Tirmidhi use it and it's none of the two. So what we need is we need a holistic answer, an answer that every time you see as a student of knowledge Hasan and Sahih being mentioned together, it both means what? It means this answer, this is what it means all the time, in every situation, this is what it is. We need to try to give you something like that. We'll stop there inshallah ta'ala. We won't mention it because the mabhath and the discussion here is too long and I definitely need a board for this. So we'll cut this one short inshallah today, bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. We are in the holidays, so a lot of students are finding this very complicated. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.